last video. So we're continuing from the last video. Last video we were talking about how to buy a domain name from Namecilo. So today we'll be taking another step on how to register or how to get a web hosting, a free web hosting. And after that, if you have your business is growing up, you can upgrade it to a premium web hosting. So let's check our second step. Let's check our second step. right, our second step here is our second step is best free forever web hosting. Then you get from this web hosting you get unlimited web hosting disk, but it's limited for daily hits. It's 50,000 hits per day. Then if you want to upgrade it, you can upgrade to a premium, right? It's called Infinity Free. So let's click it. Guys, if you found this website, our website helpful, please subscribe for more tutorials. Right, if you come to the Infinity Free web hosting, unlimited web hosting, as you see, fastest free hosting, 99 uptime, unlimited hosting, complete free, no forced host. So when you come here, you come to register, right? If you come here, you can first you enter your email, second your password, you confirm your password, then you enter a captcha. After that you click I have already read and agreed. Then the last you sign up. So as you see guys, I already have an email, I already have an account from Infinity Free. So we are now I'm going to log into my account. So let me log in. Right, then I will sign up, sign in. Right, if you come here, the first step you must take is to create a new domain name, a new account here, right? So we can click here. Right, from there says if you're a person who don't have money to buy a domain name, Infinity Free can provide you a domain, a subdomain name. You can search here, like if I say just all techno services, all techno services, then I can pick two of these one. If I want to choose this one, I can choose it. If I want to choose one, I can choose it. Then from there you can come here, you can check for the recapture, then you continue creating it. So but now you are using our domain name we bought from Namecilo. So what you'll do here is say we come here and search for this domain name you bought from Namecilo, right? The Infinity says the domain needs to point to the name servers. So you must copy this, right? If you copy it, then you go and paste it. I will show you to your domain, to your Namecilo. Right? If you come here on your account, you click on account overview, or you can point straight to your domain, to your domains. Then you can click on managing domain, or you can click domain manager. Right, if you come here, you can first check the one you want to use for name servers, then you press change name servers. Right, then if you come here, you just paste your name servers, then you go back, number 2, right? Then you go back to name 0 and you paste it here. Then we submit form, right? After submitting, it can take up to 24 hours to update imported note. Then you read this. It can automatically take between 1 hour to 48 hours, but sometimes it can take up to 10 minutes to update name servers. So right, let's come back here. Then I will search for, I will continue. Right, then it says roads, so you must tick for roads. Then you tick for roads. I'll pause the video until I finish this capture. Sometimes it can take long to allow you to continue, so let's pause the video. Welcome back. Right, I'm done. Then after that, I'll click create an account. If your name servers are not updated, it will tell you that your name servers are not pointing, so we'll wait until name servers updating. Then when it comes here, you must click, you can check here, view in client area, right? Your account is being created, you are currently setting up your hosting account. Please refresh this page. Okay, there is no problem, you can continue. We are now creating a fresh website, right? Then we click there. Thanks, the panel will now load. Let's wait a little bit, guys. This series, I want the series to take you up to the end of the website. I want your website to be look nearly like this one if you like it. So I will show you what happening if you are creating this, you're creating all these things up to you finish. Okay, let's check our cPanel. Right, the cPanel has been created. Why I like Infinity Free cPanel is because if you are using WordPress, sometimes you can install a bad plugin or a plugin that will corrupt your WordPress system. Then you fail to log into your WordPress site. So with the Infinity, you can delete. Then I will show you after sometimes in the incoming videos how to delete the plugin that corrupts your system. So now the first step here is to create, is to install an app. So we come to Soft Colors apps and install our WordPress site. So let's wait. Right, then the WordPress, you can install Joomla if you want, but for me, I'm using any. After that, here you must be carefully follow my steps and delete what I'll be deleting. Then it says in dictionary, just remove this WP. Then you leave it like that because you don't have any SSL, so you just leave it like that. If you want to be WW, you can use www if you like it. So, but for me, I will just leave it like that. Okay, then you scroll down. Here it says block. You can say WP beginners, right? Then site description, say how to develop a new website. we scroll down, then says admin. You can leave it like that if you want. You can write your name, but I like, for this one, I'll just add admin with a capital letter. Right, then on password, I'll be using my password. Right, then here says admin at alltechnoservices.yap. So this is a webmail, so I'll show you how to create a webmail, cause we want to use all these things at the same time, so we don't want to be to left other things, right? So let's scroll down. I will just select theme, just leave it like that. We'll auto call it. Then here I will send to alltechnoservices.right. Then I finished. I'll click install. Then WordPress is installing a WordPress apps application. After that, congratulating, the software was installed successfully. Automatically it's been sent to my email. So I will go back to overview. Right, let's go back to our cPanel. Then we are back to our cPanel. Now we want to install a webmail. Okay, so we come here and say email account. Then on email account, I will just remove this. Let's remove that and say admin, because when we installed there, it asked me as an admin. After that, you come here and you create your password. Right, after that we click add. Right, so to receive emails using your webmail, you must says to receive email on the email address, you will need to set the MX records. So what we'll do, we just copy this, right? Then we click MX records, then we enter just alltechnoservices, yes, name server name, then we just paste, right? Then we click add. Right, as you see, all these things are working together, so you don't delete anything, just leave it like that. After that, we go back to our soft colors, or to be easy for you, I'll just say, let's come here to a cPanel. After creating an email, then we come back to apps again, then we open a new page. Right, now we want to install a webmails, so we click on mails, then we click the first one, right, then say install. Yes, I would like to leave it like that, I don't want to change anything here, so I'll just leave it like that. Then I can enter my email account, as you see, right? Then I'll click install, then it start installing. Right, congratulations, software is successfully installed. Let's go back to all installed apps. Okay, so you want to go to our new website. So let's just check a shortcut and see what our website looks like. Oh, that's wonderful. Then this is a new website. let's go to our WordPress admin, then I'll say wp/ then admin, then now says log into your WordPress, then I will enter my password, then I will log in. Sorry guys, this is a fresh website, it's a fresh WordPress. So now what we are doing, I will show you simple things, right? This is our dashboard, then our pages stays here. If you want to see our pages, this is our pages, right? Our plugins, if you want to install a new plugins, you come here. So for today I will just leave it like that, because this website is based on how to set a web hosting and install a new WordPress. So now I think all is done. For the next episode we'll be showing you, we'll be starting developing. So I'll be changing my browser, because we are using Opera Mini, then I'll be using a Chrome. I like Chrome, it's faster. So then I will change from this one to a Chrome, where we'll be building, and then I'll be showing you our second step. I'll be showing you all these things, right? Starting installing and designing themes. So this our is a step two, okay? So we'll be now installing Ocean theme. I recommend to install old vision, and then I will tell you why I like to install an old vision. There's one thing I like for it, and if you install a new, then you never install what I want to install. As you see, this header is on sticky, okay? It's not scrolling, so I will show you how to do that. I'll show you all these ways. If you refresh this page, you see the stylish and other things. So let me refresh it and see what happening. In the future of our tutorial season, I'll be showing you all how to design these pictures, how to insert, how to install everything on this website. So let's check if you reload this site. As you see, it's scrolling from up, from down, even a picture, you see. So I'll be showing you all these things. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe and ring the bell so that we could continue with our tutorial season. As you see, our website is a fresh one, fresh. Then I'll show you everything. Thank you guys for watching. Meet you in the next video. Please subscribe.